just when you thought we weren't going to have another episode, guess what? It's here.
Guys, welcome back to the reunion episode of
It's About Time.
We're here at the NYC Watch Show at Gotham Hall, as we usually are every year, and a great time to bring back our reunion episode for this year. And we got a shitload of brands to show you. So Jared and I are going to get
a full battery roll.
Oh, yeah, and I put it on airplane mode, so I have more time this year and a bigger memory card. So we're good to go. But we got a ton of brands to bring you and what their newest stuff is, so we're not going to waste any too much time. We'll get right back to it, and we'll be right back.
Okay, the first brand we're going to look at today is Seiko, and you have basically three lines from Seiko that they're featuring at this show. And the Prospects is the first one, as you can see from their divers' watches. They have a variety of them in a multitude of colors. Blue dial and then the Pepsi dial as well over here. This seems to be their biggest line out this year. They do have their Presage, which is their dress line.
How often do you see a nice blue watch?
If I had the money, I'd do it. The blue.
And of course, okay, so you can see pretty much all their Presage line over here. This is relatively new to them.
No. Presage has been for years.
This has been redone, though.
Well, the dials, yes. They may have.
Because I don't remember them unveiling anything like this in the past for a Presage. You don't really hear about the Presage line too much. And finally, their PADI, P-A-D-I line, which is a version of the Prospects that I showed you before. A little shocking that they're at this show. Seiko, not really known for being at a Swiss high-end show like this. They aren't Swiss, but they're trying to make a name for themselves, so they've bought themselves a slot at the opening set, which is where we are right now. This is pretty cool, showing one of their divers' watches in a fish tank. So that is Seiko, and now we're going to be moving into the big boy hall.
Okay, guys, here we are. Let's going to start it off this year with Maurice Lacroix. Let's see what they got. They're new to this show.
Okay. Do you know anything about that watch that they have on the board?
Not to my knowledge. I'm not a big advocate of Maurice Lacroix, so tell me about it.
So that particular watch, when you have the watch resting, the hands just kind of fall flat and do whatever it is. When you come back up to look at the time, they readjust the action of the time.
Really?
Yeah.
That's pretty wild.
Yeah, if we can see it, that'd be cool. I mean, that's their claim.
Claim to fame on this one?
This year.
That's pretty cool.
Yeah. It's very interesting, to say the least.
And here's the line that they are featuring this year. At the show?
In New York, Madison.
Oh, I'm getting there. It's Chronicles.
Madison Jewelers. There's two locations.
Okay, Maurice Lacroix is more on the more inexpensive end of what you're going to see today. Most of their watches are anywhere between $500 and $2,000.
Oh my gosh, no.
But they have some that go higher.
Just reach out to, you can start with Madison. Did I give you my card? Yeah. So start with Madison. If you have any problems, email me directly and I'll take care of you.
All right, thank you, dear.
All right,
let's see if Jared can see this watch.
Hi.
How are you?
Hi, gentlemen. How are you doing?
Excellent.
Good. So these are our quartz, and over here we have our automatics into our masterpiece, manual, and automatic over here.
And this is your bestseller? Tell us about that one.
Okay. So this one?
Yeah.
Is the Icon Skeleton. It's the first time we've put an in-house movement inside an Icon case, the masterpiece movement. So like these, you see they all have a similar look, but this is in an Icon case. This year, this won the Red Dot Award. So it's a very high design focused piece. Display back. Try it out. Somebody.
Okay. Here's.
But I'm gonna give you, after we talk about this, we'll talk about an even sexier one.
I want to know about the one behind you. That's the sexy one.
That's the really sexy one. That's what I'm about to tell you.
Absolutely.
So that is
What size is that, 42, 44?
44. That is the Icon Skeleton. Retails at $56.90. We are doing some special show discounts and so on if anybody's interested. But
pretty lightweight. And now, is it stainless steel?
Yes, it is.
Titanium.
Stainless steel case, not titanium. Stainless steel. All right, so this is the Mercury.
Yeah.
The sexy one. So this comes out in November. When you're looking at it, it tells you time. When you move it around, the hands move freely.
Yeah.
And when you put it back on, it tells you the time.
Yeah,
that's a unique feature.
So what it is two movements sandwiched together, and when you're not looking at it, one movement disengages, but the other movement is still telling the time in the background. Hence the reason when you look at it, you can see the time.
That's crazy.
That's pretty wild.
Yes. Yeah, it is. Like, I mean, literally could be in any position and then see how it just comes back.
What's
so
that
retails at?
$7,890.
Oh, wow.
And we'll be out next month, but we do anticipate it being sold out as soon as it gets here.
Is this movement?
So if you pre-order, yes.
Limited to a certain amount of pieces?
No, this is not limited.
Okay.
But Marisa Park produces based on demand. So once we place our order, it'll be a while before we get a refill.
It's limited production, not limited edition.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay.
So they'll produce based on demand. But if you're interested, we do take pre-orders.
Are there any plans to take that from stainless steel to a titanium or a more?
No, but later on there is a black case coming out. It will come out in black. And also they all feature this quick change bracelet.
Yeah.
So you can change it to a strap very quickly.
Now that's smart.
So you push it back in, and there you go.
And that, I don't know why more watch companies don't
it's
do
so
that.
It's so easy. Even like, if, who has time to hammer
not even that.
Out?
What if you want a different color?
Yeah, exactly.
Okay, maybe you want a two-tone bracelet on it instead of
exactly.
The weapon. That really makes a lot of sense.
So as long as they have the same case size and depth, you can quick change. So for instance, all of our time only here fit our Ventura dive watches and vice versa. So you can put a rubber watch band on here, you can put a leather on the dive if you want to.
Oh, cool. Okay. Thank you so much.
No
All right,
problem.
Ladies and gentlemen, behind me is Fremont, our next brand that we have up here at the show. English brand, known for their aviator timepieces. Again, first pretty much developed by a father and two sons. And again, known for their aviator timepieces. Let's take a listen.
One Scott just showed you is the Army. The one close to you here, that's called the Arrow, which is part of the RAF. And then the Argonaut is the one on the far left. The Navy. So everything that we do, essentially, what we do better than most, or I think what we do better than everybody, and where you'll see this brand being supported across the board is durability. So where that starts or where that kind of sticks and keys into is this centerpiece right here, these three watches. So you can strap any of these three to a pilot. You can throw him into a military jet, sit him or her in that seat, and if they were to pull the ripcord of the ejection seat, they go from 0 to 800 miles an hour in 0 to 2 seconds. So most watches they suggest don't play tennis, don't play golf, don't play badminton, the worst sports of all time. And this one you can blast out of a military jet at 800 miles an hour in less than 2 seconds. So 0 to 30 Gs, you end up about an inch and a half shorter than you used to be. I was 6'4" before I started working out. Yeah, way too many, like 4 or 5 of them. I should be dead, but I'm pretty tough, but much shorter than I was. But the idea of this watch is to show the difference between the durability of our timepieces versus almost anybody else. So that's what we do special. And then across the entire collection, you have durability and toughness like that. And that's what's going on inside. What happens on the outside of the watches then is our stainless steel is 7 times harder than traditional stainless steel used in almost any watch in this room. So the benefit is, while yes, you can still damage it, you can still scratch it, it's 7 times harder to give it a dint, give it a scratch, give it a mark than anybody else's timepieces. Biggest benefit then is if by some miracle you manage to damage, scratch it, do something to it, when you send it back for regular servicing like you will do with any mechanical timepiece, we replace the bezel, the lugs, the second hand, the minute hand, the hour hand, and the main spring of the watch, all complementary as part of a service. So even when you do manage to damage it, if you're doing the most outlandish things known to man, when it comes back to us, it's basically a brand new watch, completely fixed.
So the movements?
So this one basically, we have a proprietary mechanism inside. It's basically a rubber mounting inside the watches, which makes it allows the shock absorber for the movement. So we allow horizontal and vertical movement in the movement, and and that's basically what detects against shock. Shock vibration, extreme acceleration to the ejection seat capabilities, and that's almost across the entire collection. On every piece, you see some of our advanced watches won't be capable of that, but the majority of our watches are. Also, anything that is over 43 mil, so these two here, the Martin Bakers, this one right here, the 43 mil as well, anything 43 or higher that has a closed band will also have a Faraday cage as well. So it's a smattering of very durable, tough watches. Some of them happen to be very elegant and beautiful, some of them happen to be a bit more rugged and everyday, but within the entire collection is something you can put on your wrist, beat the living hell out of, and then just go enjoy the rest of your day and not worry about it. But that's what we do.
As you can see, that's their motto. Beat the living shit out of their watches. For an airline, for a pilot's watch, that's pretty good. So we'll move on to our next pairing, which is... All right, next pairing, people. Jaquette.
Hello, guys. How are you?
Hello.
Good morning.
How are we doing? What's new this year?
Yeah, the front side a little.
Sorry.
What is new this year?
So, these are part of our automata collection, so a lot of people love these. So here, for example, this is a tropical bird repeater. So when I operate the mechanism, you can see everything that happens inside the watch. So the birds chirp, the waterfall moves, the peacock opens its feathers.
Is that a minute repeater?
Yep, it's a tropical bird repeater, yep. There's a hiding toucan in the leaves that opens up as well.
I just came from Hawaii, so can we see it?
Yeah, of course.
Let's do this.
Yep, everything's in Amazon.
Sorry.
No, no problem.
I
love watching these things move. It's the fun part about this brand. They do some shit that nobody else does.
No, they actually do shit that it's like literally nobody else does.
I know.
Actually, that's
you're gonna see
the,
is that the flower?
It's the one with the flowers. Penny Diamond in there. I'll show you that one next.
Yeah.
All right, so this is a 45 millimeter.
Yep.
It has to be a little thick because of all the stuff that goes around it.
Sure.
So I wind it counterclockwise.
What's the power reserve on it?
68.
Really? Not bad.
Yeah.
What is it, a double barrel?
Yep, double barrel, all red gold. Mother of pearl inside.
God, I know so much about this.
Everything is hand-painted in hand movements.
Can you see?
What are they limited to?
This is 1 out of 8.
1 out of 8, okay.
All right, so you guys are ready?
Yeah. You can still hear that pretty well.
Oh, wow. Look
at
that.
That's insane.
Oh, that's amazing.
Where does a timepiece like that go for?
This one retails for $609,000.
Only that much.
Yeah.
Wow. That's pretty cool.
Yeah.
That's pretty cool. But wait, Steven, you haven't seen anything yet because...
Only that much, huh?
Wait to see the next one. This one debuted last year, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
We saw that last year. That was pretty wild.
Yeah, it was our attraction piece last year.
Did it do well?
Yes, very well.
How many were made of it?
This one is also limited to 8.
How many sold?
Around the world, only a handful.
Still pretty good.
Yeah.
That's still real good.
Yeah.
Not a bad profit margin.
Yeah. So this one right here, everything is enamel, mother of pearl. And when I operate this mechanism, you're going to see the flower in here open up,
yep.
Spinning diamond in the middle.
Okay. Yeah, watch this, Steve. You'll like this.
Wow, that is cool.
Wow.
Then it closes up. Yep.
That's not easy to do mechanically. I was going to say the amount of time it probably took for that to happen, for them to do that.
Oh, yeah. Definitely. Years. It takes years. Yeah,
sometimes a decade. But what does that retail for?
This one retails for $170,000.
That's more.
$170,000? Yeah, much more reasonable.
Price range.
That's pretty cool.
These are some of their other timepieces that they have available in their collection as well.
I'd have to come back though.
But yes, definitely one of the premier brands. Yep. That do things that other brands just dream of. Always a favorite of mine here at the show, and I'm sure of Jared's as well. In terms of
really
uniqueness.
In terms of uniqueness,
yes,
I wouldn't be wearing
a $600,000 watch, but even so.
Well, I mean, some give it for free.
Yeah, you know what? I wouldn't. Yeah. Just for the heck of it. All right. On to our next brand. Jared, tell us a little bit about this brand.
I mean,
All I really know is that everything is really done in-house with this brand, cult following. It really kind of came up in the last 3 to 5 years.
In terms of like a good
mechanical watch, this is kind of, I mean, if you really look at the finishing on the back of the movement, the collage, everything is really top notch. And a lot of nice collage.
31.
In terms of size.
I mean, you could put your name or anniversary date or... It's a blank canvas. You can kind of do whatever you'd like.
One guy yesterday had on his watch, never give up.
That is 120
meters. That's what he believes in.
120.
There are many options.
Let's say not the chronograph
name
pushers,
name of your wife.
You can get away.
A kid, a date.
That's interesting.
Your name.
This one.
I can email you. Yeah, that's fine.
That's pretty rough.
I think I gave you my card yesterday.
You can see the unique style.
Yeah, because we'll obviously need to connect as far as delivery.
Most of them range between 20 and 40,000, it looks like, from what I'm seeing here.
How much would you like to put down today?
I guess
what's your requirement?
High end, they don't use metal. You can tell they use straight leather.
20% is 3,000, okay?
I believe some of them are with some
conscious. The straps.
What
is the base metal
here in the region? So, pretty unique brand. Pretty exclusive.
I could probably do that.
What's the new ones out this year?
Sorry?
What's the new ones out this year?
Yeah, ship it to me.
If you take that out, everything is new.
Everything.
I'm not worried about that.
These are the latest born.
What is the metal of the salmon versus this
watch?
One?
I'm giving to my daughter.
Same metal.
21 years from now,
this is electroplating.
We'll work that out.
Why is this lighter?
It's lighter,
significantly lighter.
Okay, so you mustn't fit with the sizes.
Yes.
It's gorgeous.
It's the aqueous, but the plastic in the back.
Yeah, it's kind of the cell phone number.
Same metal.
So they're both steel.
Steel.
They're both steel.
Sorry.
Steel.
How are you?
Good to see you. Yeah, and it's different.
What are you wearing today?
This is
the first series. There are 10 only.
And
the second series
has
a Roman 12.
Oh, okay.
I prefer the Arabic 12. I prefer that one. But we had some requests from Japan for the Roman 12 because they love the Roman numerals. How is it going?
It's great. Sometimes it's a little hard to read the time because of the reflection.
Yes, yes.
And the finger on the grid.
This is something that we're improving for the next model. But the problem is when you want to make it very readable is that you lose a little bit of the energy of the green. We have a blue, but for example, here, that's a new model. This one, we worked it to really read well the time.
Very beautiful.
No, just talking to.
Have you seen in the window? That's your piece I put in the window.
That's a smart thing. To have baguette diamonds.
I have an
FB Jorn
black
dial
gold case, but they don't use anti-reflective.
Everybody else does sticks. To have the bag at a time, which are somewhat more expensive. I know a lot of jewelers, they go for about $200 to $300 a diamond.
It does increase the value
a lot, yeah.
Douglas,
yes, it does.
Sure.
But it's very subtle, and it's still very readable.
Was it the same
position
last year?
It's just a very nice thing. And because we're so small,
we
can customize things. If you decided that you wanted any of the other ones and you wanted baguettes, we can
very
do
happy.
It.
So, like approximately how many watches each year do you guys want to use?
160.
Thanks a lot.
Thank you so much. Okay. Christopher Clark. These are pretty. These new this year?
This is new from this year. This is the Mamba one. So you have a solid gold snake in the dial, hand painted. 28 pieces.
Wow.
This is a Mamba skin.
What is that, 42?
It's 42, yeah.
42. And what do they usually go for?
Say it again.
What's the price of those?
96,000. Only 28 pieces.
This is literally one of my favorite brands for uniqueness. You see everything.
You have a double barrel.
Yeah,
for 7 days of power reserve.
Oh, 7 days?
Oh, that's
all the movement, it's upstep. So you can see all the movement from the top, and everything has been rearranged, so you really can enjoy all the parts of the movement. There's a lot of work of taking out all the pieces that is not necessary, so you really have the beauty of the entire movement to be seen from the top, and everything is in 3D. The hands are sapphire crystal hands.
Are they?
Yeah.
That's kind of different. What kind of material is the case?
Titanium.
So nice and lightweight. That is how you do it. That's why I love it.
What's the water resistance?
It's 5 atmospheres.
Okay. That's every watch should have is at least 5.
Yeah, it's very respectable.
Because 3, you're always on the borderline, whether you're going to get it.
Hold
that bag for me. Can I try one of these bad boys on?
Yeah, I'm a huge, I love this.
This will be on carousel, that rotates in 6 minutes. This rotates.
Yeah, titanium is a nice light feel to it.
It is. It's just, I'm just a big fan of
this. There's one chair at wrist.
Once you have it, you keep looking.
Literally, you can't help it. I mean,
yeah, it can happen.
Nice size, not too big.
It's like an adventure to. Yeah. The watch, you know?
Absolutely.
And this is really nice on the wrist. Like you could do like anything. Like you can't even tell it's on the wrist.
No, because they're so light. Titanium does have that advantage too.
It really is amazing.
Smart move. Oh, thank you very much. Hello.
Yeah, hello.
I don't really know you guys. What is? Tell me about your brand.
What would you like to hear?
Have you guys ever been here before?
Yes.
Yeah. They've been here. Pretty much every year.
Pretty much every year?
You haven't been here.
I haven't been here.
I was going to say.
We haven't been here.
I don't know if you've been here.
So these are all limited edition pieces?
It's not limited, but we are limited by production. We produce only a few hundred pieces. Having the higher standard in finishing. We have our own hands production. All movement are developed in-house.
There's a new piece that I just read about this year.
Yeah,
I can't remember which one it is. That one?
We have a few new pieces. We did a GMT.
Yes.
It's the moon in space. It's limited only to 8 pieces. We have one of the vintage power reserves, vintage logo of Grossman. We did a rectangular movement with cornerstone with a rectangular shape and a new version of the Menu 37. And spectacular was our first automatic movement, self-winding, because it's with a hammer.
Yes. Yeah, I was going to say that was the one. Yeah, that was it. Yep.
And that's,
how long did it take to develop the movement?
3.5 years.
3.5 years.
How long?
Three and a half years. This is not a traditional.
That's a great color.
Right now, like the movement.
I love the color. I literally just like the color, yeah.
Wow. Very nice. It's
beautiful.
Now, what makes it unique with the movement?
Never has been because normally automatic and everybody knows the rotor system.
Correct, yeah.
And we developed it, was already, you can find some pocket watches in the 17th century, 18th century. They tried with a hammer, but only on one side. And we did really a restart, a development of this kind of system, but we are winding in both directions and it has to be safe. And also, if the hammer moves only 2 millimeter or 5 degrees, we have a winding mechanism there. So it has not to move over the 28 degrees. And it's a development which hasn't been before there.
Yeah, no, I've seen so many different kinds of movements, but never seen something like that. Now, does it create less friction?
Pardon me?
Does it create less friction? Because it's not moving all the way around, you know, back of movement or anything? Interesting.
And then you have here a special click system with a reduction gearing and this on both sides. And that's connected at least directly to the barrel.
Yeah.
So if the hammer moves only like here, the mechanism is starting. So it's
really cool.
It's so nice to finally see.
What does this go for?
How much does it go for?
It's how much the price? It's 37,600 or 800 euro for US market, but without tax. So,
gotcha.
Around 38,000 euro.
Nice.
Yeah.
Thank you very much.
Did you see this one?
I did. Yeah, that was the one limited to 8, correct?
Absolutely gorgeous.
Yeah, absolutely gorgeous. Okay, Jared, tell me about Arm & Strong. Our next one.
What they do is the double balance. They have that. They're known for their resins.
Thank you very much.
Which
thank
is
you.
We'll be in touch. Absolutely unbelievable.
I have it.
Yeah, I came with him.
Oh boy, look at that one.
Wow, that's gorgeous. Good. That's gorgeous.
So, gents, if you have any questions, all of you, even you.
Yeah, tell me about the Metarepeater.
Awesome. So, resonance. This technology goes all the way back to Christian Huygens. It's a bit more refined by Janvier. It's a bit more refined by Breguet. The only difference is that the way that the escapements would communicate with each other would be that you would have to affix the actual communication medium to a fixed component. Here we have an actual free-floating clutch right there in the center.
Okay.
These two escapements, true separate escapements, are actually in true synchronization. They are actually communicating with each other. They influence each other. Why? Because if one, for some reason, were to start slowing up even minutely, it communicates to the other one that
and
it's
now
happening.
It stops.
And this one here will catch it right back up. Where this is called pure, where you see the actual escapement, the one main difference here is that with mirrored force, you can actually see the synchronization because each one of these escapements has its own seconds hands. And it's one of the only timepieces in the industry where you can actually reset the seconds hands at any time to actually test resonance. So here we go. Boom. Right? And the reason why it's called mirrored force is because where this seconds hand goes clockwise, this one here goes counterclockwise. Two separate escapements, and yet you can test resonance at any time. Just a few minutes ago, I showed these other gents that were here. This one here had actually started moving a little slower than this one after I reset. Within about 30 seconds, they were right back into resonance. This timepiece cannot lose time because since you have two separate escapements which are actually communicating with each other through this clutch.
So that's the slip clutch on it?
So
correct?
This here is the actual median for their ability to communicate. Where F.P. Yorn uses air in his timepiece, this one here actually uses a proven technique. This actually was tested at what would be called the MIT of France. They actually sent it there to test it for true resonance and synchronization. So when you think about also the fact that, Claude is probably showing the masterpiece too. It's the world premiere. It's
you
the
guys
first
have any
time.
Booklets, by the way?
You can actually take this with you.
This one?
Yeah, I'm gonna bring some more out so that you guys can take it.
Take a look, yeah.
Now,
can I bring some more out?
Is the minute repeater function new for the resonance?
So it's the first time in history that a minute repeater has been coupled with resonance. It's never been done before in history.
Can
so
we hear it?
Actually, this one doesn't have it.
Oh, it doesn't. Okay.
It's this one here, and it was in this case, and I believe Claude is more than likely showing it right now.
Gotcha, okay.
So here you also have, as you can see, the gongs are actually exposed. So they are actually exposing the entire movement, both front and back. Now, can you imagine how hard or how difficult, should I say, it is to be able to couple the chiming mechanism using two separate escapements also? With the dual time zone here, that timepiece there, it's actually two true timepieces separate from each other. Each one has their own twin barrels, each one has their own power reserve, each one works with a day and night indicator, and yet through the resonance, they communicate with each other. So that the accuracy between both time zones is at zero.
Now,
at perfect.
What is the actual run, let's say, over a few days span? You said it doesn't move. Now, I hate it when watches lose time.
Of course.
To me, that's a sign of...
Something is going on.
Right. Yeah. It should be either even or gaining time.
You have, in terms of like the cost certification, you have the -4 + 6.
Right.
But with many timepieces nowadays, their accuracy is even more because they are also using their own stringent types of testing that goes beyond what cost puts out. The idea here is that because you have a true resonance escapement, you can't lose time. You can't lose time because you have two separate escapements, again, which are communicating with each other, not allowing either one to lose or gain any time. So even on an impact, within a few seconds, they'll go right back to residence.
So how much service would it need?
Well, in terms of service, right now, we haven't heard of anyone that's actually needed service. It's very, very young in terms of, like, let's say, clients that have, you know, celebrated with an arm and strong. The only thing that we say is that at least once a year, just get it tested for, like, water resistance and all that.
What are the water resistance usually on them?
So you're looking at about 50 meters of water resistance, 100 meters of water resistance. I mean,
considering everything that the watch does now, what kind of casement is it? It's the sapphire.
So this is going to be steel, but we do make one like this in a full sapphire crystal. Okay. So this one here is called the Skeletal, and it pays an homage to the actual founder, Armin Strom, who was a master skeletonizer for many different brands. And then in 1967, he actually created his own timepiece. And in 1990, he was inducted into the Guinness Book of World Records as having created the smallest ladies' timepiece in full skeletonization. So with Mr. Claude Briesler and Serge Michel, who is the actual owner of the company, they acquired Armin Strom in 2006 from Mr. Armin Strom, because Mr. Serge Michel, his family and Mr. Armin Strom were very, very close. So they acquired the company in 2006, but they created the manufacturer in Bien in 2009, for which reason, with the mini repeater resonance, they're only making 10 in celebration of their 10th year anniversary.
It is the hardest complication in the world.
Mini repeater is the hardest one. Some clients say, oh, it's tourbillon. No, it's mini repeater. Why? Because you have to be able to truly synchronize the repeating aspect of it with the timing aspect of it, and it has to be able to resonate perfectly.
And what material the gongs are made of?
So you're looking at steel.
Okay, interesting.
But the case is done in titanium.
Wow. And how much do these usually retail for?
So this particular timepiece here, you're looking at about 345,000 euros. When you figure that even for a Patek, you're talking mini repeaters, you're already talking $600,000, $700,000, okay? But a couple mini repeater with resonance technology and skeletonize it so you can actually see it working. No one does that. No one does that. Not even F.P. Ornstein piece shows up, because obviously the communication medium is air for them.
Very cool.
Thank you so much.
Wait. So you guys will be able to make it. So this, we're having a very exclusive sneaker event at the Watches of Switzerland.
Excellent.
In November.
Wait, which watch is in Switzerland?
Soho.
In Soho, yeah. Okay, cool.
Which are gents?
Because I know that they're opening one in East Rutherford as well.
Since you said that, Andrew, you can fill it out. Is anyone from Switzerland here or not?
Here's a brand we know and love. RGM.
This may be one of Drew's favorite independent brands.
It's made in Pennsylvania. We know the guy who makes this, who is the ingenious creator of this. It's Roland. And he makes a beautiful watch. Look at this sailing watch over here with the ship.
I like that one. I'm not a fan of the one behind it, because that takes from Vacheron's stuff.
Okay, these are beautiful handmade timepieces. He usually makes anywhere between 23 and 25 a year.
That's it?
Yeah. Yeah, it's and you can see from the back the train, Pennsylvania train, because these are made in Pennsylvania. So these are actually, even though they have Swiss parts, they're an American watch. That's what they're listed as. But one of the most prestigious American watch Swiss mixes you're going to find around. And he's pretty accessible.
Now, the other thing that's unique about this, I don't know if you noticed it, but in every display case, it also shows the case back too.
That's true.
You don't see that everywhere.
No. No, he makes true skeletons. I mean, just take a look at that face.
Well, he does everything in-house.
Yes. Everything. He's the man you go to. If you have any problems and you buy a watch from him, he's the one that fixes it. It's really nice. The maker actually fixes your watch. It's really wild.
Yeah, it's really...
But again, RGM, I do like this brand. I just think it's a nice American-Swiss mix that has fine precision in watchmaking. And that's the rest of his collection for this year. So that's RGM. Jared, take it away on him. We saw him at the panel a couple of years ago.
Yeah, I mean, it's...
Sorry, guys.
Oh, no problem.
watchmaker to do that. And the difficulty is to make it that it looks clean, that it's not a mess.
Very, very few watches every year. Everything's done by hand. In Switzerland directly. Kind of like, you know, RGM, any sort of CNC, anything that needs to be done.
Goes right back to
hand. Hand wood shaving, like, that most manufacturers don't do. It takes hours, sometimes days. They do that. It's every old school method that you can imagine.
Bringing old school into the new era. You notice he doesn't have a lot out. He's only got about three.
Yeah, very few watches each year, but the watches that he sells are very, you know, obviously expensive. They're easily five figures.
Yeah.
And none of them go for less. But also you can see the complication in the movement. Everything's regulated by hand, like everything's done by hand.
It's pretty cool when you can actually see the man who invented, who made the watches, actually show them to you. So few times can you actually see
that's
it.
That's what RGM does. That's what right. What Mango Atelier does. That's what Carl Gudelainen does. That's what's great about the show.
You get to meet the men who made the product. Typically, and that's just the unique part about this fair that you don't get anywhere else.
Correct.
Especially in New York City.
This is the new model that we have in Basel.
Yeah.
So it's the movement is just another way around. So we can see the movement on the in the front, so we had to bring the time indication on this side, but also we had to do a new caliber and also the new case because it's not exactly the same because of the height of the stem and all these things, and it's slightly thicker the case, and then in this side we have a pulse of indication and small seconds.
Wow,
but it's also very clean in the way that there's no extra holes in the we can see.
That is very nice.
Now, how long did that take to make?
It's difficult to say like that because we can put another way around that we have 24 people and we are making about 50 pieces per year.
Yeah, okay.
So it's about one watch per week. That's a big one. We have the bespoke stuff that we are knitting pieces and then we have a time only and some other complications, power reserve, GMT, and that sort of things.
Wow. What's the retail price on that?
So this one, 86,000 Swiss in titanium, 98 in platinum.
I love how you see the barrel right there. How you never see that. That's amazing.
It's pretty wild.
The finishing is beautiful.
It's a big balance wheel.
Yeah.
Our escape, those two escape wheels, which gives the direct impulse to the balance wheel. And the balance wheel is made for. So we do fabricate our components by ourselves.
And it's suspended, correct? The balance wheel suspended on the bridge?
Yeah.
Yeah, wow. That's
and then it's what we call it free sprung.
Free sprung, correct.
So there's no regulator, and the timing is done with a cold weight. So on the balance wheel,
that are attached to it, yeah.
Cold ways and we can turn them.
So they're loosened and tightened, correct?
Yeah.
We can
time it fast or slow.
Wow. Absolutely gorgeous.
Wow. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Steve, how are you enjoying this so far?
No, I'm not. I'm actually enjoying myself. I'm not going to lie.
Both of you, what have you noticed? What's been the coolest thing you've seen so far?
The coolest thing I've seen was
I actually noticed
very cool watches at RGM, which I've been surprised about.
Really?
Yes.
No confidence in Roland?
Yes, confidence in Mr. Roland.
One thing
and I'm looking forward to Zenith, too. So.
One thing I actually like to observe is the fact that when it comes to yourself and an hour from Jared, asking them questions, you get to actually learn and take in what the information they're giving us, learn more about the timepieces, so I like that a lot.
Sure, absolutely. We're now moving on to Acriva. Now here's one I'm not so familiar with. Let's find out a little bit about them. We got another one. What do you know about Acriva, Jared?
No.
Another small. I mean, I don't see
In the general world, they're kind of considered a micro brand. But again, everything's done very in-house, you know, somewhat limited production per year. A little bit of a larger brand compared to like a Rudolainen or like Romain Gauthier, like a little bit of a larger following, but still a small brand. Beautiful, gorgeous pieces though.
Neither have I.
Excellent.
Are you familiar?
Some people are still buying Jack. Yes, I'm familiar. Like literally, I read watches, study watches every single day, every day.
Thank you.
All day, every day. Absolutely.
Is this new for this year?
No, it's just a new dial.
New dial.
Crivia. This is literally one of my favorite pieces. Again, one of the things that I like about them. It's probably even higher than that. But what I like about them is the size. Again, I don't do big watches.
No, it's nice to have.
It's like a 36, 38. Correct.
For people with smaller wrists, I guess.
It's but again, 36 to 38 is a universal size. Everyone thinks 40 or 42 is.
36 is actually the universal size.
This is a very nice watch.
More importantly, turn it over.
Turn it over, watch what happens.
That's where you get just some of the beauty.
What is that one retail for?
See everything.
For the Jubilee?
Yeah.
It's 144.
So don't drop that, Steve.
But remember, yeah, it's a tourbillon. It's a 60-second tourbillon?
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Perfect.
Awesome. Love this. And that's the other watch that they have on hand here. And this, again, is from Macriva.
Cyrus Geneva. No, Geneve.
Cyrus.
Cyrus. Thank you for the intro, Jared. Here's one we don't really know much about. This is here this year.
Oh, wow. The bronze one's nice.
So here's... All right, so we have time. It looks like we have a chronograph as well, which is interesting with the minutes and the hours.
I've seen this before.
You probably have.
You know Greg's dad, Tony, my uncle, down in Florida?
Uncle Tony,
yes.
Yeah, he has this. He has one like this.
Does he really?
Yeah, he has one like this.
We're going to find out.
The 12:30 panel discussion, the golden age of watchmaking, is about to begin on the mezzanine in 5 minutes. You can enter the mezzanine by going up the stairs on the left of the main entrance. The 12:30 panel will begin in 5 minutes.
I mean, it's got to be like single pusher. I want to ask. It's got to be single pusher chronograph. I'm trying to take a guess. Are these single pusher chronographs?
This is the chronographs.
Yeah, yes. Single push chronographs.
No, it's two pushers, but in another way. Yeah. Is yours or
no?
So they can be got.
It's a pusher.
Single pusher.
Yeah.
In Florida,
in Sony Nova.
It's kind of interesting.
Yeah, what are you?
I
hope they'll explain it to us.
No, no worries. Well, sorry to interrupt.
You have the start.
Yeah.
Stop. And the reset.
Yeah, he did.
Because by Cyrus, there are always two crowns. And we are using them for the functions. That's why we did it in that way.
How's the time reset on the watch? But is there like a crown that you wear for the time?
There's so many unique things.
At 3 o'clock is conventional. You have the winding. And
Oh, wow.
Date. Yeah, we have to change the...
Okay, so all the dates on them, that's cool.
Yeah, it's different.
Oh, that's different. That is different. That is nice.
That is interesting because I've never seen
it. It's different. It is exactly what we want to be.
It's
unique, different. We have our own development, our in-house movement. It's
the reason we can propose also different complications.
This is unique
complications.
That is so cool.
Now, how long have you guys been around?
Sarius started in 2011. But in U.S., it's really new. We just started.
I was going to say, we haven't seen you at the show before. Yeah.
What's the price on this?
It starts about by 13,000, 14,000. And of course, the gold is higher.
It's not bad.
No, it's actually pretty affordable.
Wow. And the water resistance on it?
Is 5.
It's 5 AC? Yeah. That's again, very respectable. It's not bad at all.
Cool. Thank you so much.
Jared, do you know anything about that? This spring.
Regulator?
It's a regulator.
I mean, that's... So you have the seconds.
Kind of like Chrono Swiss in a simpler form. It's a regulator. I do like regulators.
Okay, so you have the hours, small seconds, bottom left near between 7 and 8, and then you have the minutes just going around the dial, regular. I love that white piece. That is real easy to read. This is a different kind of watch.
Bring out your roars for a sec.
Oh, okay.
This is a different form of your regulator. So here's Dave's Aorus regulator. As you can see, it tells the hours, minutes, and seconds all on different dials. That's his diver's Aorus. This is the Tulo, which is a different version of it. Let's learn a little bit more about this.
What does that translate to for power reserve? So this is a twin barrel with 4 days power reserve.
4 days.
Yeah, so you hand wind, and they're all handmade guilloche decoration on the barrel, all handmade, hand finished throughout. So it has rounded bevels, which are done by hand and polished, twin tone frosted black gold plate, and a nickel silver color on the bridges. The wheels are made from 18 karat white gold in a double spoke design. That's our own unique kind of design, and the balance wheel is also a free sprung, and it's also our own design. They're all, the movement's all made entirely in Switzerland at our own workshop in Saint-Sulpice, Val de Travers. But I'm based here in New York. I'm the founder of the company, and I worked on the design. Yeah.
It's a pleasure to meet you.
Pleasure to meet you.
Wow. Absolutely unique piece. Absolutely gorgeous.
I like the fact that you have regulators, because not a lot of watch companies do regulators anymore.
Yeah. We this is our first edition and our first watch, and we decided to pick on an idea that was sort of at the roots of horology. If you go back hundreds of years, the precision chronometer that sat on the wall was a regulator.
Right. It's the first type of watches that were made with regulators.
And so we thought we would do that, but we would do something a little different and create an asymmetric regulating look. So you don't automatically notice it necessarily as a regulator.
You know what? I got to tell you. So I study watches, read about them every day. As soon as I saw this, I said, that is such a beautiful, perfect design. Yeah, I mean, it's asymmetrical, but it's all balanced.
Yes,
it's perfect. Balanced. Which is just amazing.
Now,
this is the nicest regulator I've ever seen.
Well, the one thing I would say that, do they have any plans in the future to add a date to it? Add a date.
Not to this model.
Like any future models, do they have any plans to do something like that?
We're working on a second model, but it's not one with a date. It's a simple time only watch again, in a 38 mil with a different design. I won't say anything more than that.
Absolutely. But you know, though, I can understand why not incorporating the date design. I actually understand it from a purist standpoint.
Yeah,
it's a purist look.
Purist,
yeah,
exactly.
It's a little bit
correct.
Of a purist feel
absolutely.
To it. Yeah.
Gorgeous.
And what do these usually retail for?
$36,800.
Yeah. Now, a lot of it hand-finished gold, double barrel, 4 day power reserve. You know, again, all handmade precious metals. That's the direction that the industry is going into. That's what differentiates a lot.
Listen,
a lot of people can do it regular. How can you do it?
Exactly. Hello, Belen Ross. Okay, Jared likes Bellen Ross. So we're going to let Jared explain a little bit about this.
What I like about Bellen Ross personally, okay, I actually am a little bit of a fan of the square watch. The reason why...
Oh my
why,
God, did you just admit that?
Yes, but I'll tell you why. It is the legibility. I mean, they're nothing special. They use Sellita movements. They're nothing great. They're not worth, I wouldn't pay the money for it, but The easy legibility is amazing. Absolutely amazing.
Let's take a look at where we got here, Dave. What's the collection look like this year?
VR05 is the new one. It's a new one for this year. Competing in the sports watch market. But the other one that I really liked, actually. So my favorite Bell & Ross was the Aaron Aval. This one looks like the Aaron Aval. Similar, but the Aaron Aval was two-tone. I'm curious to know which... Let me just see here. This is a really, really, really nice
piece. I'd go
with
that one.
Isn't that beautiful?
That one, yeah.
It's like a nice sunburst
dial.
Looking
at this one, I'd go with that. Maybe.
I mean, I like this one, yeah.
This one speaks to me.
That one speaks?
Nice
okay.
one, too.
That's from the Aaron Aval.
That's the Aaron Aval, yeah.
Because of the color.
Chronograph. Yep.
Of course, the color.
See?
I can see these two.
I went from this one now down to this one, which is funny. I don't know why.
It's actually super common.
Because of the color.
And that is Bell & Ross, ladies and gentlemen.
Wait, that's the head of Boris.
Is it?
Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, or is
Rudolph,
a brand that Jared and I and Dave all love.
Well,
close to our hearts. Here they are. Welcome in. Hello, hello.
I wanted to tell you. Say thank you guys for releasing this one.
Oh, that's a pretty one, yeah.
I have to tell you this. 21 years from now, when my daughter graduates college, she's only 9 months old, this is the watch I'm giving her.
Okay.
Look forward to wearing it every day, whatever it is, but you guys are literally the most unique, the best. Love it.
Thank you.
He's got an Oris on too. Dave.
Yeah, a little bit. I'm sorry to interrupt.
No, you don't. Just talking. Thank you.
Here's the regulator from...
Nice. A guy had the titanium... did you see a guy walking around here with a titanium tungsten bezel chronograph he's got? Some guy had the chrono, the titanium tungsten one.
Yeah.
Gray one. I was like, oh, let me see that watch. And he was by the Casio booth. It's a beast, but it's light. It's like, you know, it's cool.
By far my favorite brand.
Really? Thank you.
Now I have the bigger one
of
this.
It's so cool for me to come out here and to meet new people and see, you know, how you appreciate what we do.
Yeah.
Yeah, you do so much. I mean, Spration, Excel, you know.
I literally watched all your guys' videos from Basel this year, saw everything. As soon as
did you get your bear back? Did they steal the bear?
Yeah, they brought it back.
Do you guys have any shops in particular in the U.S.?
You mean monobrand stores?
Like for headquarters or anything in the U.S.? Like any main offices here or no?
Yeah. We are in Norwalk, Connecticut.
Oh, Norwalk.
Yeah.
Okay, excellent.
Yeah.
Excellent. That's very interesting.
Yeah, you guys do a great job, especially with your skeletons, your regulators, your divers pieces. I mean, you're right up there with Rolex in terms of, we were doing an episode, the Submariner versus this one, the features and everything else like that. And you guys are very close in what you do.
Great color, man. That's
a great color.
That dial color is amazing,
this is,
right?
This is
we had the other one.
I have the larger one of that.
Reef.
I have the larger one with the sub.
Isn't it gorgeous?
The sub dial.
Yeah. Can't stop looking at that. You know which guy did a great thing about it was the
beautiful timepiece, beautiful company. Great to see him here at the show.
Citizen, right? Tipo. These are our customers. And we make watches for people who need to work for their money. You have some money to spend on a watch, but it must make sense, right? Things must make sense. And $2,000, $3,000, $4,000, $5,000, yes, but.
It's a perfect
at some point, it's not making sense that much anymore.
Yeah, absolutely.
No, not everybody can afford a $5,000 watch.
Yeah.
But they can afford a $500 watch.
Yeah.
And you guys make it look like a $5,000 watch, but it's really you know, you're selling it for $500, which is your price point. You know what I mean, anywhere in that.
The quality.
You can see them anywhere between, you know, even on eBay, you'll see them anywhere between $800. And
yeah,
2000
exactly.
is where your
secondary
your meat market is, yeah. And most people can afford that, especially for a good diver's watch that lasts decades. So, you know, we definitely appreciate that, and that you have a lot of different designs. You have which is the one that came out this year with the 8-day?
The 10-day?
Oh, 10-day. That was the one that on. I'll take this.
Yeah, take it.
I mean, when I mean that's unbelievable, how light is that?
This
wait, in terms of weight, which one's heavier? Let me ask you that.
What, the Zenith?
Yeah.
Slightly heavier. The Aorus is slightly heavier.
Slightly heavier? Yeah. Okay. Probably not by much. I'll tell you that. But again, you don't get that 10 day. I mean, that one's unbelievable.
The power reserve on that, I think, is 48.
Okay. Yeah. It's not terrible at all.
No.
Honestly, that's real nice.
Real light. I like titanium. The main reason I like titanium, especially both of these watches, is because they're hypoallergenic.
Yeah, that's true.
You can't get allergic to them. I have one of my best friends is allergic to stainless steel.
Turn that forward.
So he can't wear any type of, anytime he wears a steel bracelet or a steel head, he breaks out and hives. So when you put titanium on, you don't have that problem at all. You don't have those properties, which is a smart thing to do for people who have allergies. That's actually a pretty big part of the market people don't even realize.
That's true. You're right. Absolutely.
Oh my God, so nice. I'm telling you, this is
your first time at this show?
Here, yes.
Yes, that's what we thought.
At Windup, we have been showing for several years.
Yeah.
And then Time Crafters at the time, we were. That's 6-7 years ago. First time here, yes.
I have to tell you, it was a pleasure to meet you.
Absolutely.
Hello.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
What do we have that's new this year?
What is new?
Yes.
Quarter hours, half hours, and full hours.
What is really new?
Yes.
Really, really new?
That would be the question.
Because it's introduced yesterday?
Yeah, I was going to say, I literally just, you guys were featured in Watchville.
Right. It's the U.S. limited edition.
Yeah.
Number 3 in a black DLC case.
All you look at on your watch is your
mellow
hour
yellow dial.
We just extended that hour
degrade
hand
function
all the way to the edge.
That means
to reach the indexes,
a little bit darker
right,
from
the
outside. Then come light in the inside.
That's interesting.
Well, the whole concept zero, is that, you know,
with
the
Meister signal, it's always 0, 1, 0, 2, 0, 3,
really
up
aren't
to
that important.
9, and then goes to 10, 11, 12.
I want you to kind of slow down.
Look at this watch. 0, 1, 0, 2, 0, 3,
0, 4, then 50.
And then 50.
Why?
Why 50?
That's the good
question. It's a U.S. edition.
Plus, I've not made a documentary.
U.S. has? How many states?
50. 50 states. Uh-huh.
50 states. Look at the caseback. On the caseback on the class, you see an outline of the United States of those 50 states. And we have made 50 limited editions.
Oh, that's cool.
So 50, 50, 50.
Very nice. Very nice.
Actually, you know, it's
price point $2,400.
Look, it's really going. It's almost done.
Right.
It's kind of theoretically, it should have been $2,550.
That's why we're 50 states. Now we give $5 back for the milk service.
Oh, there we go.
So,
very nice.
Hold out the note or hold out the rest.
And is this your first year here at the show?
No, I was here.
No,
it's my third time.
Yeah, absolutely. I don't think they've been here.
No, there's going to be a selection. Times, but we do have some manual wine.
Very cool.
And then they also have a day-date. Like, they have different complications.
This is cool. This one's cool.
At a base manual wine, and on number 2, a unique test.
That's a Sotora Mate X.
The rest
limited
of the
edition, 150.
So when you see uniques in the house.
And what's that one go for?
No, the number 2
and
is a
price point is at $2,400.
It's not bad for a 50
price
point.
$4,750.
Still not bad.
Still not bad for 50 made.
It's not bad.
I like the fact that, again, you got that jump out. It's a different way of showing the jump out.
No, because you see through the transparent.
Right. It's like a skeleton jump hour, which is something that you don't see from other brands. So that's really cool. That one jumped out at me as I'm looking at all the watches.
Again, they do all different kinds of complications, which are really nice. Anything from no date to date, big date.
There's your moon phase over here. That's pretty cool with the jump hours. A lot of these are one-handers.
Now, because
really
our offices and our headquarters are in Munster, Germany,
really cool.
Our watchmaking all happens in Switzerland.
And these are made where?
In-house.
Where in Germany?
German brand?
Where in?
We produce in Switzerland.
Ah.
Trap cool. For us.
Yeah.
So we have a partner in Biel, just at the corner of the headquarters of Omega.
Cool. Thank you
watch
very
itself.
Much.
It has like pressure things where it goes up, goes down. It's just
the liquid really tells the time on this watch.
Yeah.
Any
of
Heights watches. This is something I have not seen before.
Yeah, it is, like I said, this is going to be the most unique watch that you see today. Ruble 4C will be the most expensive, and F. Bijouren may be one of the best independent brands that you see in terms of niche market. They're exploding. These are just, you know, big time people. They're not for everybody. Like, this is obviously for unique occasions. It's not really for, I mean, this will get you attention when you walk into a room.
Oh, that's for sure.
They're also very expensive pieces. Very, very expensive pieces. Yeah, they're not cheap at all, but yeah. Just get all the info here. It'll be
Let's learn a little bit about these ciphers. Hello. Tell us how this tells time.
Oh, how it tells time?
Yeah, through the liquid.
Okay, so basically, let's start with. Brad, I want a sec. I'll start with this one because maybe a little bit easier to see. So, pretty much, how do you tell time? The idea is that you're going to tell time using the fluid.
Yep.
So you have two types of fluids here. You have the black fluid, as you can see here,
right,
and you have a clear fluid on the other side.
Correct.
The two fluids work in more of a contrast like this. Okay. The capillary inside, we produce in our factory in Neuchâtel, Switzerland. Mm-hmm. The capillary is bombarded by helium over and over again. We make sure the capillary is 10,000 times more water resistant than any other watch in this fair or in any other fair around the world. This is connected to bellows. The bellows house the black liquid and the clear liquid, the left and the right. On the left side, where you house the black liquid, we put in a thermal compensator. Why? Because liquids tend to expand and contract when exposed to heat or exposed to cold. This thermal compensator makes sure that the capillary inside the liquid stay at one temperature no matter where you go, so you don't have a problem with synchronization. All this comes together and works with a movement, in this case, which is the new movement by Eric Coudray that we made. And you can see on the back of this movement, what you have is a large circle over here and a hand. That's what we call the cam. That cam interacts between the mechanical part of the movement and the fluid part of the movement. The hand can jump 13 times to each one of the different cams to make sure that the fluid is working in unison or within 1.5 microns of the mechanical time. So we can say today, this particular watch will be within 1.5 microns in terms of keeping time. 1.5 microns is 40 times thinner than one of the strands of hair on your head.
Wow. So how accurate is that in seconds?
Yeah, I was going to ask the same question.
Again, 40 times thinner than the hair on your head. So if you take this watch, tolerance is generally what on a regular watch?
Tolerance for what? You mean how much?
Plus or minus.
46.
Well, that's COSC, but
COSC.
Yeah. But sometimes it could be minus 15, plus 20 a day, like general.
Depends on
Let's
the
go
brand.
With COSC,
depends
which
on the brand,
is yeah.
It depends what they're going to tell you. But absolutely. More or less,
four
tolerance
to six.
Is probably around. Not to disagree.
Yeah.
So our previous models that we had problems with, when we first came with the technology, we had many problems. We didn't have a thermal compensator in the watch, and we had a much smaller cam. This is the reason why we can actually increase. You can see the watch's buzz right now. You can actually tell the time by looking at the liquid right here from top.
Okay.
So when I say 1.5 microns, I mean in time here.
Okay.
Okay? Within 1.5 microns, you can tell the time using the liquid itself, which is a massive improvement from around 6 minutes on our previous models.
That's pretty cool.
This is an Eric Coudray movement. If you're familiar with Eric Coudray, he's the gentleman who fixed the gyro tourbillon for Jaeger. If Jaeger is to make a phone call in our industry for someone to fix one of their watches, then I can tell you that gentleman is a genius. Because Jaeger is one of the top factories in the watch industry.
Correct.
No matter what, no matter who, no matter how, with all the respect to AP, to Rolex, to Patek, to Breville, Jaeger is
the watch
Jaeger.
One of my favorite brands.
Thank you very much indeed. Gentlemen, you know your stuff.
I have a dual matic, I know it very well.
Thank you very much. Absolutely. So this is Mr. Coudray's movement.
Yeah, wow.
Which will probably have a tolerance of plus or minus within the 1 to 3 minute range, not the six minute range, because that would be more like Omega around the corner, because they do their 6 minutes. On this particular piece, you're looking probably 1 to 3 minutes in terms of tolerance. In terms of the microns of the fluid, we're within 1.5 microns. This is a major step for us, because when we first made the watches, we had major problems with the thermal compensator wasn't there, with the liquids going crazy, and with the cam, the improved size of the cam, which was 1/10 of the size of that, we have more control of the liquid, so more precise in time. So our timepieces come with a 5-year warranty, way because we believe now we have a final piece. It generally takes 5 years to make a caliber.
I was going to ask you that question.
It takes around 5 years. You can go around all of the guys here or SHH or Basel. Everyone tell you more or less 5 years. In 5 years, some movements never get fixed.
Correct.
There is a movement that I made at my previous company, which was, I won't say who, what, why, it was a Fodoranti movement. The Fodoranti was put into a limited edition. Until today, that particular factory takes back that watch and fix it because it knows the caliber never worked correctly. We've had many challenges in our first 5 years. We finally now have come after making a concerted effort with a master watchmaker to produce a movement that works in tandem with our fluidic timers.
I have a question. A watch like that, what does it retail for?
This watch retails at 55,000. Entry level price is 39,900. The technology costs a lot of money in R&D.
Absolutely.
50 people in our factory, 12 of them have PhDs.
How many are made a year?
380 watches, approximately. But we're looking to go larger. We want to go bigger, but first we had to make sure that our product was 100% ready and perfect for market. I think this is not only a good timepiece, but also a sexy timepiece. The sapphire crystal is a piece of sapphire. If you take a look at the crystal, the way it's domed, and you compare it to any other sapphires in the watch world, no one has this type of finish ergonomically. Please, feel, take a
What's impressive is how, like, you know, the big brand, you know, now, like, they're offering the fact that you guys are offering 5 year speaks to your brand.
Oh, wow.
By far.
Yeah. How long have you been around?
2012. We're babies.
That's real good.
But wow. But if you take the guys, I've been in the watch business since 88. If you take the other guys in the factory, we probably have 100 years of experience.
Yeah.
I could go to work tomorrow for a large brand. I'd much rather do something like this.
Absolutely.
It's tougher, it's harder, but wow, it's a lot more rewarding. When I go and sit in the factory, I sit with a bunch of geeks that go out on bikes and I have a great time with. So it's a lot more of a cool idea. Our idea is, look, this is your time that's gone by in your life. This is your future. This is your present. This is your now. We want to tell time. Today in the watch industry, you're going through the same problems. The Swiss watch industry is going through the same problems they did in the late 70s and early 80s. Apple has killed the business.
Right.
Seriously. Everyone here has a different form of the original.
Correct.
1679, Jürgens, tick-tock, tick-tock, tick-tock. We don't. We're not against our industry. We're with our industry. We just want to bring something completely different.
Doing it in a different way. Right.
Something cool.
We want you guys to wear our watches. Fluid time has been around for 4,000 years. For 4,000 years, 4,000 years ago, the Egyptians used the Seledra to tell time. The Greeks had another form of Seledra. The Chinese that were just here had water clocks, way before Jürgens did tick-tock. When you get into a Ferrari today, when you drive your Ferrari, do you have a speedometer or do you have liquid? You have a liquid readout. When you get on a plane, when you're really angry, you want to murder someone, you're sitting there like this, do they do tick-tock? No, they give you fluid. Calm down, take it easy. Today in schools for little children, for babies, they put fluid clocks on the wall to keep everything more calm. Time is like a river. It's constant. It doesn't go tick-tick-tick.
It's
tick,
fluid.
Tick.
It's fluid.
Now let me ask you an interesting question. Watch breaks. Fluid comes out. Is it harmful in any way?
No. No way whatsoever. If the watch breaks, first of all, you're going to have to break the case plus the capillary,
right,
which is quite hard to do. Actually, one of my very good customers, somehow the watch got smacked onto concrete. He broke the glass. The capillary was still intact. But if that happens, there is...
But there is no... Okay.
No
good to know. Well, thank you so much. Very interesting.
Well,
as we can see, this is known for one thing and one thing only. That is the dollar signs. So, we're going to have somebody ask.
$1 million watch.
Yes. Let's go take a look.
GMT, I'm not kidding. Greenwich Median Time. It is.
Here's your Google force.
It's a universal time that everyone uses. Pilots, everyone.
Actually, they do.
Those are expensive.
Drew, is the watch on the very back?
The blue?
Look at the blue one.
What does that retail for, Jared?
I'm taking out a 30-year mortgage.
I think it's $1 million close to it. So your glove rotates every 24 hours.
So we're not stealing that one.
And you have four tourbillons.
Well,
look at this one. Tourbillon,
I would give you
the tourbillon is 4 minutes. The inner tourbillon is 1 minute. You have a GMT function here for another time zone.
How long does it take them to make these watches?
Well, we're going to find out, Dave.
I
Thank you, sir. And look at this one, too. Yeah, they're all beautiful. Look at the blue collar. Oh,
they are one of the most expensive brands on earth, so we do want to take a look at these.
Whoever else for us. Never heard of them.
Oh, that's pretty cool. Okay, we just found out the price on the blue one.
The blue one is actually $695.
Uh-huh. They have one that's
now look at this collar. This is unique.
I have alpha. Sure, they may not have it here because it's so
old. I'll say the ceramic.
Yes. But no, I have to ask you how much the most expensive one is.
Yeah, we just launched it yesterday.
You'll have the wealth. See that volume?
Exactly. That's what I mean. No, I'm fine. Always upstairs. The panel's going to
go. You see the mirror?
Absolutely. They want you to see that.
We're gonna close that shop now and go home.
I like that.
Try it on.
We launched this just for the US market. First time we've ever used this type of material. This is a double tourbillon ceramic.
Oh yeah, boy. Double tourbillon.
You can see here on the case back, this is the older version. You can see we created a lot of new sapphire plates for the case back and the watch itself. New strap for us.
Each one of your watches is a work of art. Should hang in the loop.
Thank you.
I think you should sell your watch.
I should sell my kids.
There's another reason behind it then.
It's going to take out a 30-year loop. Yeah,
that's the ATM right there.
Thank
you.
Hi, how are you doing?
Appreciate that. Thank you.
Good, thanks.
Very good. Very, very nice watch.
What's the most expensive watch you guys have?
The quad in the front, that's $820,000.
Oh my God.
The quad GMT?
Yeah, it's with the globe.
Globe. Oh, yeah.
It's platinum, $820,000 US.
How many are made?
11.
11 pieces on that.
Oh, with the globe.
That's your most expensive, $820,000.
Look at that, baby.
It's a sporty watch. We wanted a sporty strap. You can do a blue gator on it as well if you want something a little dressier, a black gator, but I think that strap fits the watch, the sporty nature.
We're going to ship it with three straps. We're going to ship it with that, with the rubber, and with an
alligator. Oh, very nice.
Very nice piece. Most expensive brand here. And it's pretty wild. We got a lot of.
I would almost deflect this to Federico Iosa. Federico talks watches. One of his favorite brands, independent brands. This brand has come up majorly in the last 3 years. They're, you know, like a kind of small independent brand, but they're almost mainstream. It's one of the only brands that's really kind of done that. Literally, this is probably one of my dream watches to own, personally. Everything hand done. My favorite part about them is the blue hands. Absolutely gorgeous. Also very comfortable. They come in all precious metals. All complicated with power reserves, dates, moon phases. I mean, it's like a, reminds me of like a Breguet.
It's got that Breguet look to it. Yeah. Who is actually over there? We'll get to them a little bit later. But really cool. Very simplistic.
Ridiculous.
Someone in Singapore.
Wow.
Pick it up. Yes. I'd say Hong Kong, but Hong Kong's having, you know,
a little bit of issues. Yeah.
Dez beat second. These retail again, you know, high five figures, and they go for even more. You can hear they can go in the hundreds of thousands.
But it's crazy just to do a vertical tourbillon.
Perfect. Thank you.
Vertical tourbillon.
So this guy's a lucky watch.
That's unbelievable.
Oh yeah. Bye. It was nice meeting you.
Absolutely unbelievable.
Brand knows what the reputation that we have is already up there. It's up there. It's astronomical. And the thing is that you can see the quality of his brand change. It's like red wine. You start off one specific way, but after the years, you just start seeing all the improvements and all the evolution actually happen into the brand. It's amazing.
And the thing is that he's really big on the concept of his inventions. So if you actually look at the part number that we're on, we're the only manufacturer that can actually make the power reserve closer to the crown. Everybody else is always going to make it away. And also, this specific watch is actually based off of a marine chronometer. So when the watch is actually fully wound, it's wound at zero. So if you wanted to, you can use this as a stopwatch. Because the thing is that you wind it when you actually want to start. Once you start elapsing, then you actually know how much time has actually passed. We won't do that on automatic winding because it's constantly winding. You'll never actually use the stopwatch feature on that specific timepiece.
Wow.
No, it's crazy.
Yeah,
this is all right, here's Brigitte.
Now, JLC is considered the watchmaker's watchmaker. Breguet was the watchmaker that started it all.
Patented everything.
What do you do?
That's correct. They do have an issue. And they look a lot like the Luis Nardino. You know that these design types of
things. They have like a plane on top.
They have a there's nothing.
Hello.
What's new out this year? All this
some
on
you
here?
Can just like stamp on.
Which one do you like?
When it's
that's
done,
more important.
When it's done by hand.
I'm personally.
This one. Let's go with. Let's go with the great owl. What is that?
I've been restored.
Yes.
He's not at the show, is he?
No.
Do you have an equation of time
left
yet?
No.
The equation of time. Gray on gray, yeah.
That's it.
But we close at 6 o'clock today. I'm paying today also.
How do you?
Okay.
Yes, we'll see there. You're welcome. Chronograph, titanium, feel the weight.
Ah, see, everybody's going towards titanium. Same thing.
Nice job.
People are going towards titanium, and mostly because, as I've said before, because of the allergy-resistant properties to it.
Okay, first of all, not just lightweight, and also scratch. It's much, much harder than the steel, so it preserves much better, yes.
Absolutely.
And also, more understanding. It's not as shining as than the steel.
Correct, exactly. Yes.
So it gives a very, very distinctive
nice.
Low
really,
kilo.
Really, really nice.
I'll tell you, titanium's great. Anything titanium is great.
I do. Ceramic, titanium, love them both. What's this retail for?
This one is $31,000.
$31,000?
Yes.
Really not bad for it. Like, just feel how heavy that is. It's stainless steel.
I know. It's a heavier piece.
Much heavier.
And these?
Sold.
Yeah.
So you feel the weight, basically, the movement.
Yeah.
Yes.
Same thing with the Zen. Same thing.
Which one do you... Now, do you still think that this one's lighter than that?
Type 20 or...
Oh, yeah, this one is lighter than that. Yeah, that's what Zen is kind of one of the claims to fame are.
Do you guys have any books this year by any chance?
Or the magazine? And you want the catalog?
Yeah, absolutely.
You can see the rest of your collection.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. She's good. She's good like that.
And the watchmaker that I really started with. Thank you so much.
Do you want one?
Oh, sure.
I'll take one too. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
And the magazine's over there.
Over there? Oh. So, that is Breguet, everybody. In my hand.
Over here. If you would, that would be wonderful. And we'll move on to Blanc On. This is a brand I particularly like. They're pretty simple.
You guys know the history of Blanc On.
And Jared will inform us on the history of Blanc On.
Okay. This was a brand that was actually dead for a very long time. Of course, you can see it started in 1735, but then it ceased to exist. Gentlemen, some of you may know, famous by the name of Jean-Claude Hubert. Bought the name with a business partner. It's for like $1 million or whatever it was. They turned this company around. That was his huge claim to fame in the very beginning. Was buying the name. He made a vow that when the industry was going through a force crisis in the 70s and 80s, they would only produce mechanical and
they would, you know, obviously pin the hopes and dreams on it, have it be very successful. And he ended up selling this brand for a massive ton of money, like making a huge return on our investment.
So he believed in the automatic timepiece from the beginning.
Strictly mechanical and nothing else.
Similar to what Oris does.
Yeah. Oh, they only produce that. Now, listen, I don't know if Blancpain ever did quartz. I know at one time, for very, very brief, believe it or not, Oris did do quartz.
Very briefly.
Not long. It was maybe a year. And now those pieces are very valuable.
Very valuable. Very. Kind of like Rolex when they went to the quartz in the 80s.
I mean, listen, everyone did it just about.
Absolutely.
This was one of the brands that never did.
And I think right now the the trendy thing to do in the watch industry is to make a smartwatch. No matter what brand you are, I think everybody wants to do it to see if it'll sell.
It depends. If you're in this segment, no. Other segments, yes. More balanced.
You can see this segment is holding off.
But no, it's not.
But that would be the closest comparison to what we have today.
Well, I mean,
hello, what's new this year?
This year, we have like some limited edition pieces. The set may go with blue ceramic dial. And we have some titanium 55 inch.
Can you see that one down there with the black strip?
Yeah.
And this is a 43?
It's a 45.
45,
yeah. That's a scaffold.
I could see you in that.
I like the design of it.
This is a complete hammer.
Yeah.
That was a 43-millimeter.
You can see the triple date.
The marker's beautiful, huh?
It's having a hard time.
Blue marks for some
courses.
Yeah. So you have, right. See here, you have the date, the month, the date.
Yeah.
And yeah. And again, like I said, complete calendar, so you never. Both of our don't have to reset maybe once a year.
It's your triple date moon phase. Yeah. And what's this go for?
Yeah.
This one.
Yeah, it's
is
a hot one right now.
Which one?
The blue dial. Okay.
Really not bad.
Not bad for a triple date moon phase.
Yeah. That's. And you know what's even cooler about that? It has the dye that bezel. How often do you see that?
What's the water resistance on it?
300 meters.
Wow.
There you go. That's really good dye bezel.
Wow.
That's what I like about that.
Wow.
The only thing I don't like about it, to be totally honest with you, doesn't have a diver's.
It's right there.
I wish they made it in a steel strap.
I'm not a steel strap.
Yeah.
You can always fit it with a steel.
That's good. Yeah, that's a good option. It's good you have that. A lot of the upper brands don't even have that option. You can't even fit them in steel.
That's so interesting.
Yeah, I'm 6'4", 250 pounds.
Which is smart, because a lot of people enjoy, listen, I'm going to have a diver's watch, and I want to go in the water with it. I don't want to waste it on a leather strap. That's absolutely useful.
Oh, but this strap was also water resistant.
That's more of a fabric strap, so yeah, that could go into.
So this is silicone and rubber. There's no, like, there's no leather on it. Like, if you have you, did you feel it?
Yeah,
there's
that's more of a synthetic strap. Yeah.
There's no leather on that. That's got to be the most unique piece we've seen.
One of them. I like it.
Wow.
I do like it.
That's real.
So this is something we may have like overlooked before, Breguet, but damn. Diamonds, double escape. I mean, that's ridiculous.
You could definitely see some rappers wearing this.
How many carats does that have to be? If you have to ask that.
Well, you can see all the diamonds in the middle of there. There's probably about 250 diamonds in the middle, followed by... followed by the...
Because he's being a wise ass, this guy.
No, I'm not, because I have one with about 200 diamonds in it.
What?
I was.
250 diamonds, and then you got the...
That's ridiculous.
The baguette style around the back, probably about 50 of those. So you have about 350 diamonds in there.
Wow. This is going to be a couple hundred grand easy.
You know, that may be one of the most expensive watches here at the shop.
And here's the ladies' version. That's no slouch either.
It's ridiculous.
So, Breguet bringing out some heavy hitters.
I mean, honestly,
yo.
All right, gentlemen. Here's Omega. Everybody knows Omega. What? Here's the collection from Omega. We all know.
No,
we all love them. You did a nice job with this watch, Terry. Look at this one over here.
Which one?
The Omegas.
Now, they also do make a 39.5mm version of this. Just to let you know.
This one?
Yes. You didn't know that.
I did not.
I got you. Ask me anything you want to know about this brand.
Well, I bet you do.
Like this blue again? Well, the blues I love. This blue.
Dave's like a kid in a candy store right now.
That's like
Dave's like a what?
Kid in a candy store.
Yeah, I like this.
Dave, do you like Omega? Do you like the yellow one?
Oh, they are a beautiful watch.
They are a nice watch.
I'm surprised they don't have the...
That's okay. Once you get a hang of it,
Constellation's up.
It'll last, right?
I'm only seeing the
day down there. Eventually, it'll get
this.
Maybe not
once.
I'm only seeing basically...
So these are all the
Seamasters.
These are the Seamaster Planet Oceans Aqua Towers. You know, the other thing I'm surprised they don't have that Speedmaster.
Yeah. They just got a small selection out here. They don't have their... It's just they're showing their water collection.
Those are nice.
Which one?
The bronze one right there? First box.
Bronze one on top. Okay, Jared, tell me about this watch.
Guinness World Record.
What is this guy?
Dive into the Mariana Trench.
Current record holder for the deepest dive watch of any brand anywhere in the world.
The ultra deep.
Zoom in heavily.
How many meters?
10,926 meters, so just over 32,000 feet.
32,000 feet, so you've got, you know, about 6.5 miles down. The deepest part of the ocean is like 7 something?
Mariana Trench is where this was dope, yeah.
Yeah. Wow.
So this is our one-of-one prototype, and this is the normal production model.
Gotcha. So safe to say, like, relatively waterproof, you'd say, or at least water-resistant.
You would think so.
Water-resistant.
You would think so, right?
Wow, that's incredible. But how much, like, how many ounces or grams?
Weight, I don't know. They weigh actually pretty similar, because this is actually titanium that was made from the submersible.
Okay,
that strapped it down.
Yeah.
It's pretty
how many of those are there?
On the submarine itself.
Mega made, I believe, 5. We have 3 viable models, and this is the one that went down.
Oh, wow, that's the one.
It's the one, yeah.
That's the one.
That's very cool.
That's actually cool to be in that presence of this.
That's all pretty awesome. Time.
To all you viewers out there, this is the first time that this is being shown in public.
It's amazing, right?
It's amazing what robots can do these days, you know?
It's just the insurance and logistics.
Absolutely amazing.
Well, as you can see, ladies and gentlemen.
And honestly, that's a big... I mean, that makes Invicta look small, which is crazy, but that's unbelievable.
You're welcome.
And that is Omega this year. That's their highlight. That's what they're featuring. Like I said, they're all water this year. Okay, we're moving on to Carl F. Bouchier. Boucheru, however you want to pronounce it. A couple different ways to say it. This is a cool brand. I had bought one of these in Switzerland back in high school. But now they are much more expensive than their Bouchier offshoot, which primarily makes more of a quartz timepiece. Carl F. Bouchier is a Swiss watchmaker as well, and they have a lot of different designs.
If you can make me a phenomenal deal, then we can talk, but if not, I'll definitely get to talk with Ron.
Let me talk to Ron. Would you want to take them with you today, or would you ship them to you? Well, if you walk up today,
you can just ship
it to you. No. If I ship it to you, then you're responsible to pay the tax.
That's right.
So again, Carl F. Bouchier. As you can see, they have a variety of styles here. Including the movement that they have showcased in here as well for that timepiece. Okay, Jared.
Hand cycle wrist scissors.
Langenzone.
Well, Langenzone just announced this week that they're coming out with their very first stainless steel sports watch, big day, big date, integrated bracelet, 40.5 millimeters, $28,000 US retail.
And here it is. Speaking of,
wait,
it's right there,
here?
Right there.
Which one?
No, no. This
oh, no, that's not, never mind. That's not it.
It's this one right here.
Elongate Sony.
German brand.
I had to put it off.
This may be, like, if I could afford a watch, this is the one that I would certainly purchase. It's the first time ever that it's done. Big day, big day. The movement is finished perfectly.
It's not super legible.
I know a lot of people are like, oh, you know, this is wrong. Let me tell you something at the end of the day. People hated the Code 1159 by Audemars Piguet. I don't really care. Great watch. Simple is beautiful. That's what I always say. And what they've done with this, they've maintained the quality of their movement, which they're known for. You could see the three-sprung balance wheel. The level of finishing is absolutely amazing. Is it expensive? Yes. But take a look at the Royal Oak, and also take a look at the Nautilus too. I mean, everyone says that, you know, this brand is joining the game late. You know what? I'd rather be late and get it right than never do it at all. That's what I say.
Good way to put it.
Absolutely. I'd rather be late and get it right than never do it at all. That's me.
Yeah. I would say.
Why not build these chronographs? We don't like so much the
but the so this is one of the watches in the industry that does the time, but it also does things digitally. As you can see, digital is the number readout. This is probably one of the most famous German brands in the world. Extremely high quality. They're known for finishing their movements the same on their $20,000 watches as they do on their $500,000 watches. And, you know, they're complicated. I mean, listen, they're known for their dress, beautiful pieces, but the fact that they're coming out with a stainless steel watch, give them credit, give them respect. And it's a very, I mean, it's a beautiful design. If you really take a look at the iPad here, 3.5 millimeters is a gorgeous size.
Great size.
Too big. Occupy all the space from the knees.
A lot of brands don't do 39 millimeters. They do between 40 and maybe 42. The fact that they're playing in the middle is really wonderful. And it does feature 120 meters of water resistance, as well as Swiss Super Luminova going all the way around. But my favorite part about this watch, besides the beautiful blue dial, everything is so balanced on it. The big day and the big date doesn't take away from the aesthetic of the watch. It has a small second. I mean, obviously they don't have it here. It's going to be going into limited production later.
If you wear a watch like this, you want people to notice it and say, what the hell is that?
They announced it.
Right?
I would personally buy it. That's just my opinion.
Nice brand.
Yeah.
Uniquely designed.
Well,
Zenith.
Drew, what are you wearing on your wrist today?
What's on the wrist? How funny you ask, Jared. It's my Zenith Defilab.
Which we did an episode on.
We did. One of the hottest watches on the market this year, the Skeleton Defilab with the D. So, when you look at Zenith, listen. You think of Zenith, you think of going out in the space. I think that they're known for what? Dropping the watch from the Earth's atmosphere?
No, they're known for their upward marrow movement.
Yeah, known for a lot of different things. But they have a lot of different claims to fame. We're going to check out what's new with them this year.
I'm going to let you take this one away.
Here they are.
Here's my watch. There's your watch. There's your watch. There's your watch.
How are they selling this year?
Wonderful.
Yeah.
This has become our best seller. Our bread and butter.
Well, here's the thing I love about it.
We're making it interesting. We're adding new
new colors, yeah. And the materials.
Yeah.
Here's the thing I love about it. Number one, you have the skeleton with the date,
yeah.
Which is pretty rare.
Yeah.
Number two, it goes both ways. You can go backwards and forwards with the date, which is something you never see.
That's true. Yeah, that's true.
Never.
Right.
You can't go backwards. You can only go forwards with the date. So I think that's a selling point that is very unique.
And to be honest with you, I never thought of it.
That's why I'm here. So, I mean, if you think about it, I was doing that the other day. I was going back and I was like, holy crap, this is a lot easier to set the date than you think.
Yeah, instead of having to go through
31 dates when I can just go back one?
Right.
Because I think if you try to do that with other watches, they break.
Most of the other ones.
The movements will break. So you've designed a movement so it can go both ways.
For the movement, right?
Right. Here it doesn't hurt you. Because you've designed it to do that.
Yep.
So I think that's ingenious.
Yep.
As you're getting all the collection, I think the Defy Lab is great. I mean, what's the price point on this now?
The Defy 21 is starts at 11.2.
Yep.
And now we're introducing the Carbon at 17.6.
Nice.
But of course, we also have the gold. But it's really our bread and butter. It's really it's an amazing thing. And it's, as you know, this one is it's all about pushing the button. I mean, maybe not on the black. They don't think it's going to show very well. But look at this one. Ready?
Oh yeah, that's second.
Hundreds of second chronograph, fastest chronograph, mechanical chronograph on the market.
You guys also do a thousandth of a second chronograph, right?
We are working on it.
We're working on it. That's going to be amazing.
We've promised it to 50 very selected customers.
Oh yeah, absolutely.
And. But the hundredths of a second is amazing. One rotation per second.
Thank you. All right.
Oh no, it does the job. I love this line. I think it's been great for you.
Mm-hmm.
It really put you back in the spotlight.
And really, it's back to where we belong, because it's new technology. We've been very always known as the more advanced brand in terms of technology, timekeeping, and time measurement. And the Defy is. Terribly contemporary collection.
And you see, when I first, I've seen a lot of Zeniths on cruise ships.
Yep.
Okay. And the problem I've always had with Zenith up until this watch was, I'm looking at $10,000 watches with a leather strap.
Right.
It's pointless to me. When you have anything that's 10 ATM or more,
right.
What am I going to do with a leather strap?
True.
I'm not going to buy a watch at $10,000 if it doesn't have a metal strap for it. But you guys, have went to titanium like everybody else. That's the new thing in the industry now. And I heard the number one reason is because it's hypoallergenic.
Yeah.
So this way nobody is allergic to it.
There are many things about titanium. It's the weight.
It's lighter.
It's
more durable. It doesn't scratch as easy.
Honestly, it's very pleasant to wear. It's very comfortable.
Yeah. Very. I've had no problems with this watch once I buy it. But they're more affordable now. You've actually come down. Even on the secondary
we've
market.
We've always been the true value of watchmaking. So if you think about the pricing for throughout the collection, you're getting a good amount of a watch for a reasonable price.
Absolutely, sure. And when you can have watches even at the $4,000, $5,000, $6,000 level for your quality, people can afford it.
Yeah.
You know, if they keep them up at $15,000, no, and you shouldn't want to break the bank.
Of course not.
If you're going to compete with other brands.
And I've worked for the other brands that are in that price bracket, and it's limited.
Sure, you should want to compete with Omega in that price point. Because you shouldn't just have to compete with Rolex.
Right.
You should want to compete with Omega and,
Rolex should be the standard, and I think Rolex is a certain price level.
Sure.
Any brand that has respectful technological interests.
And what are the warranties on the Defy Lab usually?
It's 2 years plus one if you register online.
Yeah, plus one, which is what the industry is going to the standard now.
And actually, we introduced a re-edition this year for the 50th anniversary, and we offered a 50-year warranty in service.
Are you serious?
Yeah. Really?
On that limited edition.
Oh, the limited edition one.
50, yes. 50, wow.
Everybody's like 50 years, or 50 years. But we stand by our product.
How many and 50 100, pieces?
150 pieces.
150 pieces. Wow. I'm telling
Until
you,
three.
These three last.
Yeah. Yeah.
Wait. Try one of them on.
Yeah.
Try one of them on.
Give me the blue.
The blue?
Yep.
You're not gonna dare to wear the white.
As much as I, it's after Labor Day. I couldn't do it. Sorry.
I've heard that one before.
Just not possible.
Just face
no
it
white after Labor Day.
Yeah, that's it.
Yeah, there's the blue, and there's the with
I like the
blue.
I like the one on your wrist a lot. It's slightly smaller.
Okay, but these are very comfortable.
Production? Yeah.
What do you think of the one on your wrist?
It's actually just
very comfortable.
Now
they've designed the strap where, and I'm not a fan of leather straps.
Yeah.
But they designed it to be very comfortable.
It's silicone,
and
it's very lightweight.
It's very lightweight.
It's new technology,
put it on your wrist.
We have to be careful, make sure that
They actually, it's more comfortable than I would have expected.
No, it's an amazing.
As you get to see what I'm talking about.
Wow.
It won't be in the store because they've been.
And I'm not a big fan of it.
I'll tell you something, this is actually a really nice size. And the date is so clear. You know, my only thing though is I would probably go with like the white. Because this was a little harder for me to see.
You could go with anyone you want, but they're extremely comfortable. And they do impress.
Yeah, you can't even tell that it's on your wrist.
No. Great job from Zenith this year. One of the highlights of the show. Yeah, right. Let's take a look at these. From Beauvais. Oh, yes. Beauvais is known for their eclectic. One thing I like about Beauvais is they have that pocket watch look. They never got rid of it. They kept it on the top. I like watches that you can stop from the top. Yep. I do like that because it doesn't dig into your wrist on either side.
Exactly.
So you take it from the top. I always thought they should go back to that design. The problem is you're trying to develop a stainless steel watch strap that will fit that too, because not everybody's going to want to wear leather. That's the tough part.
Yeah. You know, a bracelet design would be interesting, but it's got to be the right bracelet design.
Right. It's got to fit. And that's where I think it becomes really integral. Yeah, they got a lot of interesting. This is. What do these go for in here? How much are these?
So these are the Brainstorms. They're a 48mm sapphire case. We will only make 60 movements, and then the Brainstorm production will be finished. Five different dials, and USA is 318,000.
It's the nicest one. Yeah.
Yeah, it has our patented double-faced flying tourbillon. It has got a 10-day power reserve on a single barrel. It's got the precision moon. It's got the sapphire disc big date window. And the case is actually our trademarked sloped case. So you can see it's sloped.
Yeah.
And the movement, it's an 8-degree incline, and the movement is made at the same 8-degree incline.
Is that all?
That's all. Something.
And it's machined out of a single piece of sapphire, correct?
It's one single block of sapphire. So it's the largest sapphire case there is. It's the only sloped sapphire case there is. And in order to get the polishing so that it would be perfectly clear and you wouldn't have demarcations, it was really, really, truly a nightmare, because you can see not only is it curved, but the bezel is part of the sapphire case, which has a demarcation there. So it would really is a nightmare. We're only able to produce a couple cases a month.
Oh, I can imagine.
Yeah. For the manufacturing of the movement, it was also, you know, a challenge, because it literally is at a slope of 8 degrees. So in order to create it, we actually had to build tools that would hold the movement flat while we were building it at a slope. Because it's not staircased up and it's not propped up. It's actually thinner at the bottom and sloped at the top.
Wow. I gotta tell you, any time that I see,
took you a while to memorize all that. Didn't you?
Actually, if you were putting one back, you talked to the production manager.
Oh, I bet. Here's the other models that they offer at the show this year.
Red over there. That's
amazing. They have some of the greatest colors. I gotta tell you that right now. Look at that red. Yeah, and that's what you gotta do as a salesperson.
How much do you think that goes for?
Oh, these are, you know. Well, why don't we ask them?
What?
The ones in this case, what are they range? What's the price range on these?
So this one is called the Virtuoso 5. It's a retro broad minute jump hour. It's actually four timepieces in one.
Oh,
so it's got a dial on the opposite side. You can use it as a pocket watch or as a desk clock.
Oh.
It's $70,000 red gold USA.
Oh, outside of the $70,000, I would have made love to it.
That's amazing.
It's insanely affordable.
And what about over here up the top, Ron?
On the top, that is, with the red gold, that is called the Recital 27. It's also a novelty for this year. It's on our trademarked sloped case. It's got three different time zones. The second and third time zones tell you if it's day or night. And also on the second and third time zone, you get the option of 24 different cities. If the city that you live in is not one of the city options, we can customize it for you. So right now, this we're in New York, but for Eastern time it says Miami. So if you wanted to say New York instead, we could. And then at the bottom, you'll see that it has the precision moon for north and south.
And what does that go for?
This goes for $85,000, right? Gold, USA.
Oh, wow.
It's not bad.
That's three time zones.
Three time zones.
That's incredible.
Forget dual time zones. I could be three places at once.
And it's super easy to operate, to control.
Really wild.
That is wild.
Really wild.
Really.
And it looks so complicated. At first, I was really intimidated, and it's so easy to set. Once you learn how to do it, it just becomes intuitive.
How much does the middle watch go for?
The middle watch is a little bit more. That is a new novelty for this year.
Wow.
It is called the Virtuoso 9.
Oh, the first one.
Oh.
This one just, oh my God, I like that one.
That one is mind-boggling.
Again, you got the crown up on top, which is good.
So it also converts into four different timepieces.
Ooh, four different time zones.
So pocket watch, table clock, wristwatch,
and wristwatch on this side.
Timepieces. Wow.
Timepieces, jeez.
So you've got,
and I love
the
color
here.
Too.
You've got your hours here. You've got your second hour time zone here with your 24 city days. And then your minutes are central, and then you've got your power reserve indicator here.
Unbelievable. And how much does that one go for?
I'm going to double check the USA retail doesn't have it.
Give Dave a special price. I'm sure he'll whip it out.
Yeah, I don't want to touch
your ring
for anything.
That's true.
But the color is amazing. That's eye-catching.
That's called a flanque dial. So you know the flanque dial is, if I get my glove out of the case, is that you put the lacquer or the enamel base on it, and then you polish it and put layers and layers and layers of lacquer on it and polish it so the surface becomes glass. And it's a very, very old technique. It takes a lot of skill and a lot of time, but that's why that dial just jumps.
Pretty wild. Hey, let's take a look at Mont Blanc. Not just known for pens, but for watches.
Oh. Not just pens.
Just to let you know, my favorite, the salmon.
Yes, the salmon dial is always interesting. What's new for this year from Mont Blanc?
Look at it, the salmon dial.
The salmon dial is the big one, right?
The pulsar graph with the Minerva movement, 100 pieces in the white gold.
That color's amazing.
You have no idea, it's one of the most.
Then you have the perpetual calendar next to it. And of course, the Axo Tourbillon.
That's got a nice
28 pieces.
Perpetual calendar.
With the Minerva movement. Yes, perpetual calendar and GMT.
Pretty wild. And what's that one go for?
I was going to ask that question.
The gold one? Rose gold?
The rose gold, yeah.
The rose gold is a Riesek in-house movement. It's called Nicholas Riesek. It's a monopusher chronograph. With the GMT as well, in-house movement also.
Is this the first time you guys have put the Heritage Collection on the mesh bracelet or no?
Yes.
Okay.
That's one of the mesh or Milanese bracelet just came out now.
I love the bracelets. Yeah. So comfortable.
Well, the collection in his heritage is inspired by vintage pieces.
Absolutely.
Which explains the Milanese trend.
Love it. Yeah. Absolutely love it.
It's a vintage take on
what
some of the pieces.
What's the perpetual calendar do?
And it comes in the option of this, and it comes in the option of
the perpetual calendar is a watch that you don't need to keep changing the day after every month.
It always tells
31, 30. This knows exactly when it is during the year. It's amazing. Very, very tough to do. So you never have to change the day.
So it always changes automatically.
Change the correct
I just can't put it on this because this is a great price.
Really wild. Very expensive. Ladies and gentlemen, all right, here we go, guys. mb&f. This is outside the box thinking and expensive.
Look at that color. Wow. It's like a his and hers.
Beautiful designs here by mb&f. Very, very exclusive type brand.
What?
Oh,
there's Roland.
No, that's
true. Oh, yeah. Now he's over there.
Oh, there's Roland.
Just go say hi.
She got to say hi to him.
Right.
So, you know, he leaves one of the tours.
Let's go see what's more from mb&f over here.
No, check it out. See if
go for it, yeah.
See if they can make me a HM4 stock.
Nice talking. Nice talking.
Guys. Yeah.
So today. Good, how are you?
Oh, happy that I'm here.
Good.
What's new this year?
What's new? A few variations of things you might know already. The HM7 Aquapod in platinum with this red bezel.
Right.
The HM9 Flow over there in rose gold. Also, we have a few legacy machines, including the Perpetual, of course. There is a LM1 in platinum, a few things. But
what's the price point of the red one?
The red one is $198,000 US dollars plus tax, of course.
What's the water resistance on that?
50 meters. So it's not a diving watch. That's not the point. But yeah, you can
swim in the pool. It makes sense.
It's like a tribute to divers' watches.
Wait, how big is it? 47?
It's actually bigger if you take the outside bezel, but the lugs are, as you can see, inside, so it wears pretty easily on the wrist. It's much smaller on the wrist than you might expect.
What's the height on the watch, do you know?
Off the top of my head, something like 20 millimeters.
It's not that bad. It's not bad at all. And again, something like that is probably not going to be too heavy. It's going to be a little bit more lightweight.
Yeah.
Steven, try that one on.
Try this one.
That one?
Yeah, you'll love this.
Sure, I'll get it out for you.
Someone that you see.
So I put my other watch.
Oh, here, I'll take that one there. Put that one again on the trash.
Yeah, you'll like this one, Steve.
You know that strap, the buckle works?
I think so.
So just push your hand through, and then snap on the back. Oh. Might be too small for you. There's no click. It just snaps on like that.
Oh, okay.
And then like this. And obviously you can push that through as well.
It's fine. Yeah, it's fine.
Let's see.
Wow. Damn, look at that bad boy.
How much is that?
Yeah, how much does this go for?
Off the top of my head, 180 approximately.
That's not bad. Look at that. Now, tell me that's not one of the coolest things you've ever had on your wrist.
If only I had my black card.
Oh, only.
That's pretty wild.
Is that nuts?
That is pretty
wild.
Don't
drop it.
See, you're wearing what's on there. Hey, how's that for a...
That is so cool.
That is cool. Pretty wild.
That's a wild timepiece.
Can you get it off?
It's unusual, yeah.
Take a look at our wrist, guys. Arnold & Son, very old brand. Look at this one.
No. Look at this one.
Oh, boy, that globe one sticks out to me.
How are you today?
How are you?
Excellent. These pads are actually really great to have. I even need one now, from the launch and stuff like that. That's cool.
That's what they're there for.
What's new out this year?
New this year, the Time Pyramid Tourbillons.
Okay.
And then we went down in size. We still do have the 41.5 millimeter Nebula, but this is the Nebula 38.
That's pretty cool. What's the price point on this one?
25. Haven't done it in steel yet, but this is in rose, limited to 50 pieces.
These are nice.
Get there in steel.
We will.
And it has the sparkles in it.
I think it's set for next year, that first half of the year. Look, at the end of the day, we use the same movement, so it's not, it's just a different case.
It's just a different strap.
No, and case, because we didn't have the 38 millimeter case of steel, but the movement fits this better. It just looks a lot better in a 38 than a 41.
Again, I like the skeleton look, and I do like the design on the bottom.
It's very pretty. It's really pretty.
Very well done.
Thank you.
This is the first time you guys were at the show?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's why I think we haven't seen you here before. What's the one with the world over there go for?
So we have one right here too. This is the Globetrotter.
Globetrotter, yeah. What's that?
This is the Night Edition. So that one was released last year. This is this year's version. Same piece essentially, but more as if you're looking at down at the northern hemisphere at nighttime.
Right.
So we applied like little pieces of silver to make it look like night lights.
Ones came out.
Yeah. This.
And what's this one retail for?
This one retails at 19.
19,000.
Oh wow.
Very nice piece. Very nice.
Thank you.
Oh, thank you so much. All right, here's one I haven't seen before at the show. Really unique. These kind of remind me of my Epos. Okay, Epos does the very same thing with the night sky. And very interesting design here. I'm guessing these are a little bit more expensive.
Four years ago.
You got it for your... And more night sky pieces here.
the booth. Really nice, interesting brand we haven't seen here before. Another interesting watch brand over here. Hello.
Yes.
It's Falcon. What's new for this year?
You've seen the Maximus tourbillon, the largest tourbillon in the world?
Huh. No.
27 millimeter, 6 minute rotation, 4 barrels parallel. It's an in-house movement patented by Carbinaus. You have four barrels parallel, and the way you rewind it, because of the torque, is with your three fingers. You can do it with your, you can try.
That's interesting. That's pretty cool.
It's very sensual. And this is only to set the time.
What's the power reserve on?
54 hours, but the accuracy is exceptional because of the 4 barrels parallel, so the curve is constant until the very end.
What is the accuracy run per day?
2 seconds, for amazing accuracy. The weight of the tourbillon is 1.35 grams, as opposed to an average of 0.5. The torque is very, very strong.
And what does something like that retail for?
$165,000. Comes available in titanium. We also have white gold, yellow gold, rose gold. We have the Maximus Royal, all set in diamonds.
Oh, wow.
Baguette, invisible diamonds.
Love
we also
baguettes.
Do it in rubies.
So they're all individually cut then, correct?
Yep. Carbinaus is really a company that started only with one piece for one customer. Then they evolve into small limited edition of 14 or 41 pieces for ladies. This is limited edition 99 pieces. Tribute to America is 50 because you have 50 states,
right.
Hawaii, Alaska, Continental, and the names of the four presidents of Mount Rushmore.
That's pretty cool.
Hand engraved in gold.
Wow.
And you can personalize it with your signature. Now, I'll show you something even more, in my view, telling. The same watch, we have a customer in California who asked us to do, he sent us a photo of his ranch. And this is the photo of his ranch with at the entrance of his ranch. He's the only one in the world to wear it. And on the back, you have the ranch instead of Mount Rushmore, hand engraved in-house in Neuchâtel. But the tribute is really something that is interesting. We now do tribute to Texas. This is tribute to Texas.
Oh, that's cool.
That's cool. Pretty wild.
So down the road, we're going to do tribute to, we have a retailer in Florida, in Naples, and we're discussing making a tribute to Florida. Tribute to Naples, Florida. Or tribute to yourself. So you send us your own, anything that you like.
You customize it, of course.
The company, Mr. Zorek, is the co-founder of the brand.
So nice to meet you,
nice
by
to
the
meet
way.
You. Nice to meet you guys.
Great work with everything that you guys are doing.
Thank you.
Absolutely.
And you have 44 now in-house, from the watchmaker, the engraver, the enameler, the symbolist, because some people, they want a watch full of symbols that only them can understand the symbols. So they have a dialogue with the symbolist, and whatever is in the watch, you're the only person in the world to understand what it is.
That can be good or bad.
Absolutely.
Because I'm guessing if that person dies, there's no retail value on the watch because nobody else gets it in terms
unless
of...
Unless they have a decent
unless
watch.
They have, yeah.
Oh, another thing. Every watch comes with a book of symbols.
So almost like your own code?
Yes, and yeah. The codes are described. For instance, this watch, the Led Zeppelin one.
Led Zeppelin?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Zep.
Okay.
This watch was done only single piece for one client. Now, this watch has an intrinsic value because everything is in platinum, gold, etc.
Right.
You have the intrinsic value. Second, you have the brand value. The third, you have the symbols value. Here, in 20 years down here, Led Zeppelin will be a legend. Actually, it's a legend. It will be even more. So I'm sure that if it goes to the auction, it will go pretty high.
It's an interesting concept.
Yeah.
I think that's really cool.
I mean, it's,
it really is cool. Your customization, is for people. It's all, everything's a one-of-one basis.
Yeah, they have everything.
So they have all the code.
What they need is their image, their vision of the world to be on their wrist.
Right, which is an interesting concept. Unique to have.
So, yeah.
Cool, thank you very much. Very interesting, guys. Thank you. We'll end today with Chrono Swiss, our last one on the docket. Hello.
Hey, how are you?
Good.
Are we live?
Yeah, I'm still alive. It's like my 58th brand.
Are we live?
Yes, we're definitely live.
Welcome to Chrono Swiss.
Yeah, you were asking about this brand before. What I like what they do is they have beautiful jump hours.
Yeah, so actually we were featuring a few of the jump hours here.
They've been here every year since we've been doing this. My main question is every year the same thing to them. Did you give me a jump hour with a date?
Jump hour and date combination
yes.
together? I don't have it in our current collection. I don't know if that's a particular combination that is developed yet. So
I know other brands have them, the jump hours with the dates. I was just wondering if I was waiting for you guys.
Not within our family.
I'm waiting for you to do something with this watch, okay? Just like that, and throw a date right down there.
Well, this is not a jump hour. This is a regulator.
But something like a regulator.
I have a regulator date.
With a date, but the jump hour is the one I'm waiting for. Were you to throw a date somewhere around, I don't care where the heck it is on the watch. I'm waiting for you guys to do that. Every year I come in, I ask the same question.
We have the
Oliver Munzer brand,
the,
so that's
the pipeline, which is a retrograde second.
Right.
Coming out next February, March. Retrograde second in very much this design.
It's very interesting because I like your designs. I really like, they're not too big. You can go anywhere between 38 and 42 millimeters, which is really smart. Okay, because a lot of people don't have big wrists. Everybody keeps thinking that you want to go bigger and bigger. Why? It's stupid after a while. What are the water resistance on most of these?
Most of them are 50 to 100 meters.
That's smart. Everything has to be 5 bar. And I like what you guys do in terms of the look of it. I like the
onion crown.
Yep, the onion crown.
The design is the same for the last 40 years. We try to keep the...
Yeah, they do a nice job.
DNA together.
They do a nice job.
And at the same time, we try to be non-conformist because 500 watch brands, you want to do something different.
And what's the price point on these?
It's from 7 to 8, gold, 15, 16. These limited the 3-sec regulator, 9.9 to 9.3 in steel.
Very cool. Yeah, that was Chrono Swiss I was telling you about. They do a nice job. Nice job. Oh, thank you very much. Great job. Drew.
Okay, everybody. Ooh. We're back.
Guys.
Boy, oh boy.
Let me just tell you something. This may have been the best show that we went to in general. Being beside these guys, and especially, I got to tell you guys this. I'm going to flat out admit it. This is the guy that got everything started right here. If it wasn't for him, I wouldn't be where I am. Wouldn't have the love that I do. Made connections today.
Oh, he did. He networked.
Absolutely unbelievable.
But absolutely. Guys, what was your favorite brand of the day?
I had two. For me, it was Oris. Always good to see them. Of course, me with the Clean Ocean. And then also, surprisingly, Bell & Ross. I'm a big fan of it. I found one watch in particular that was just released this year. Pretty affordable price, but it had the beautiful blue dial. And, maybe I'll have a chance to go work with them.
Absolutely.
What
I used to get?
Mine was the Grusam Rubel Horsam.
Okay, let me help him.
Grubel Horsam. I like that watch.
That's
really cool. Very unique. Had its own style. And the second one I liked was the watch that had the flower that expanded and contrasted.
Yes.
That was sick.
Okay, that was, Jacques Drouf.
Yes, one of the first ones we saw today. Dave, what about you?
It would definitely be Oris.
Oris.
And RGM, I was really impressed with.
He liked RGM as well.
I was really impressed with the watches that he came out with this year.
I had to go with Zenith myself.
Zenith,
I thought Zenith was really cool. We saw their entire collection of the Defy Lab, plus Oris, I was thrilled to see. First time, I was wondering when they were going to finally show
and,
up. There.
And we met
guy.
The CEO.
Met the CEO, great guy. And guys, we saved this episode for our reunion special because we knew it was going to be the longest. And after about an hour and a half of footage, you probably wouldn't want to see us again for another year.
We've been here for, what, about 4 hours?
Yeah. I mean, we got a lot of footage. We got a lot of information.
We hit every booth except for one with G-Shock. We didn't give
a No, I'm not going to give that the time of day. I'm sorry. Not even with all the memory I got in my camera. I can't go there. But
wait a minute. Do you think they enjoyed this episode?
I think so. We're just going to have another reunion episode.
I think we're going to be doing a lot more.
But absolutely. And guys, thank you for joining us today, and we'll see you on the next episode of whenever it is.
It's about time.